such a fascinating state of affairs.
Okay, folks, we have New Zealand. Auckland is here. The Harbour Bridge is here. And we are situated here. And this is Simon's Street, right here. And there is a cemetery right here. So we're going to go into that cemetery and have a look further within there and then further around Auckland. Amidst the oak trees here, some wonderful old oak trees within this very old cemetery, we'll start off by looking at this quite old piece here from 1899, tombstone within the cemetery here, and you can see the four around the one configuration there leading into the one. There was something atop it, but that has fallen off. Now there is another mighty statue tomb here. Interestingly, you still have the, well, for a start, you kind of have the edifice around here with the central pillar, with the formation of an obelisk within here. Really interesting symbology right there with these parts here sort of circling around those little pillars right there, I think. This reminds me of a scene within a video game, strangely enough. Down further here, you can see these further little pillars with what appears to be a kind of energetic-like look to them. So that obelisk right there within the cemetery. We have a very old obelisk here. The interesting thing about it, I think, is that it has the veil on it with the tassels there. So a kind of broken obelisk here, very old, and that veil, as if the obelisk is sort of within this old cemetery. There are many notably Masonic symbols. Now up here you have this obelisk, and interestingly enough, the foliage kind of sprouts out the top of it. And if we have another look at it, there we go. So it's rather like a church, this obelisk, which would be an eight-sided obelisk, rather like the churches with the foliage coming out. And also within St. Stephen's Church, within the grounds there, you have that obelisk with the foliage coming out. So this is an example of that. Now further within the cemetery here, we have configurations like this. So we have the pillar in the centre, the central pillar. And in this case, we have the pedestals around. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, there's one missing here, 7, 8. 8 pedestals around, I would suggest. And you have the rope here. So the rope symbology right there. Now this rope symbology is carried on through other parts of the cemetery. In fact, here would be more of that rope configuration. And of course, so right there, the rope kind of joining, if you will, the pedestals in this case. The pedestals around the ritual edifice right there, around the edifice. You can see the rope within the Masonic Lodge also. Karangahape Road is just over here, and this is a Jewish section of the cemetery here. Over here we have David Bowie with that lightning strike coming through with the red and the blue, fire and water. Now here we have some Masonic symbology right there, quite obvious. The further swastika right there within this Jewish cemetery. And of course, that would relate to earth, air, fire and water, that swastika. And then just some further symbology through here. Just a brief look. There's your pentagram right there within the cemetery. The pentagram's right there. Once again, within the Jewish section, of this cemetery here, just off Karangahape Road. So Queen Street is just over here, runs down this way. We'll have a quick look at this bank right here. So this is Queen Street going down here. We have the Baptist Tabernacle right here with the classic kind of Greek-esque architecture with the Corinthian pillars of light. Over here we have the bank with the Jukin and Boaz right there. We'll have a particular look at the lighting fixtures there, which would in a way resemble the logo of Amnesty International. Due to only a couple of hours sleep, I was immensely tired when shooting this video, but nonetheless, so I forgot to turn the audio on, but nonetheless, we'll proceed on. So here we see the 111 figures on that bank, and always look at the lighting. You can see the astral Eta and Pingala serpents there of the spine of the Kundalini system, the chakra system, with the crown chakra represented by the globe, the lighting perhaps on the top. Atop it. So this would be on the corner of Karangahape Road in Auckland and Queen Street, the main street. So as we proceed around the corner here, we will see the Baptist Tabernacle building there, and that Baptist Tabernacle building would represent light as per this illustration in a book by Charles Leadbetter. Further down Queen Street, we have this MLC building right here. And indeed, you would have a kind of replica of this in Martin Place in Sydney, and there is also one in Wellington in New Zealand also. So you can see the mason up there with the fasci of light, I would suggest. Here we have the Town Hall on Queen Street, and you can see the orbs there with the central pillar in the centre, among other aspects there with the clock tower, reference to time, with three doorways right here, red doorways, that veil right there, veil-esque in a way, with the pillars of Jukin and Boaz sort of hidden in there, with the archway over the top. If you look clearly at the carefully at the details, you can see that archway. Many people would not notice this. Now here we have another archway, and interestingly enough, you have the glass in the base there, among other aspects. And indeed, with third eye sight, if you will, you would perhaps sort of visualize things going through the floor in a way. And you also have the well references also, which kind of go through the physical floor in a way. So there is this perception beyond the physical space, I would deeply suspect. Okay, so Altair Square is in here, and there's this ugly looking gateway, Maori type design, but terrible looking this, it's just terrible. So that's Altair Square there, that's the Town Hall right there, and coming around this way, we have a building around here we'll check out. So below the prominent V of event there, we have the Ferguson buildings right here. And you can see the water there, the water line. And you can see this water line in places like Wellington, and you can see it in places like Sydney also. Now, there are these further discs here, and it's interesting that they're kind of emanating out of that central disc, it looks like. So just sort of pointing this stuff out, the water up there will surely have something to do with the migration up, if you will, through the various elemental dimensions. On the street here, advertising for what would be a movie with configuration, the eye, and Egyptian iconography here, and interestingly enough, inclusive would be the Stargate symbology there, which just gets repeated over and over and over, interestingly enough. So just that was the town hall up here. Interesting configuration on this building here with the orb in the center, and that's something I can just show over and over and over again. Anyway, going down this building, the lighting as it happens, the kind of pillars of light there, you can see the lighting around there. That's our Ferguson building, Civic House, right here with that water line on it. And then moving this way, we have this grand building here, and you have the central pillar right up there with yet another orb type configuration in the center, the four or eight around the one sort of configuration going up there. Now there are the building angels with music, the arts and so forth, various configurations there with the cherubim up on this building, interestingly enough. And further down we have the obelisks right there, so quite an ornate building here in Auckland. Here's the floor, the checkered floor of the Civic building, and the ceiling with the geometries atop it. There's a further look at that building. So up here you can see the water line up there also, if you look carefully. If you really look around, you can see these things. So here is a stepped pyramid on a further building. And if we look down, this is Queen Street here. Interestingly enough, there's this lonesome G up there on the building. So 187, you can see that waterline type there, the magic circle on the floor, magic circle on the ceiling. This is the flower. This is a further curious building. You can see the lions there, the geometries there, the lions, the gargoyles, the water coming out of the mouth examples there. The Guardian building further down, and you have those pillars. Now you can see those type pillars in Nelson here. Here's an example, and Nelson, New Zealand, and you can see the four orbs atop them, which would represent the four elements, the orbs. So back to Auckland here, and here are those pillars. This is Queen Street right here. If we go through the pillars, there would be the magic circle on the ground here, and here is an example. Looking the other direction, you can see that magic circle a little bit better between the pillars. So walking further in, the Guardian building, and you go across the interdimensional space here of the checkered floor and into the lobby. Now, a reference to time there, you often see clocks around all this business. So, distortion of time perhaps. So the four on the ground around the one, the magic circle in the center. And within there, you would have that kind of greenish bluish, perhaps representing water with the fire, that red ring also, so water and fire. And you can see the geometries of the ceiling, the configuration of lights, also this kind of circle, magic circle, if you will. Now, further within here, my camera's not going to pick it up very well. There is the four around the one kind of configuration there also depicted within the ceiling. Looking over to this region, we can see a further magic circle configuration, and indeed you would have a stairwell situation above here, a kind of reminder of the Queen's House in London and that sort of thing, with foliage going up the Tree of Life, if you will. Further within here, you see the waterline also. This is within the lobby here, right here. So that waterline above the heads, interestingly enough. Michael Hill, the building here on Queen Street, you can see that waterline up there also. Here's the Ferry building, and you would see the pedestals up there with the orbs, spirit orbs atop them, I would suggest, with the archway in the center. Around the port, you have Neptune represented there and the lions. Neptune here with the foliage at the thigh, the cornucopia there. This shipping container was about, and interestingly you have the secret handshake going on there, and now this is a very kind of secret societal thing. So we have the Queen's Arcade here, and you have Jacqueline and Boaz, little pillars there. I thought that was quite interesting. This building is curious with the pillars, the people coming out of the pillars, people as pillars, four pillars right here with the three archways, this well in front of the building, in front of the pillars right there. Very curious. and a further look at these, so you can see the four grails there, the four around the one. The fire represented the light, the foliage, the Vesica Pisces right there, interestingly enough. So now we'll just look at this shot of the harbour bridge that I took for a moment, and this huge boat and a person doing a bit of maintenance on the boat. But anyway, I thought I'd have a quick show of various things that would have potential occult affiliation that I shot on my very quick trip through Auckland, New Zealand. I hope you enjoyed the video.